Hi viewers, myself Dr. Lakshmi. Today in this presentation, I'm discussing about flipped learning and blended learning. What is the background of flipped learning? What are the technologies we can think of using when we administer flipped learning activities? What are the challenges we do face in conducting flipped learning approaches? How to overcome those all difficulties and challenges? Being a faculty, what is a key role we may have to play in the home learning activities? And within the class, what is the role we may have to play? As a facilitator, we may have to play a role as a mentor. We may have to conduct learn-to-learn activities, or we may have to provide feedback, guidance, etc. Ultimately, what is the benefit of bringing the culture of flipped learning more and more in the teaching learning practices? Being a teacher, we may have to reflect ourselves why we should adapt flipped learning. Sometimes, we may not be able to provide excitement for the performers, outstanding students, or for the toppers we may call. Sometimes, struggling students cannot learn better when we go with certain speed and certain rapport. There will be a boredom for those students. Always, teacher focuses on average, but we may have to fulfill the needs and the expectations of varied learners, performers, as well as struggling students, as well as average. How we can provide the need of these three categories of students? It is possible only when if we increase flipped learning approach or strategy more and more in our teaching learning practices. It is possible only when we take care of flipped learning activities. It is possible by providing the right content in the right time and planning activities based on these categories and doing assessment both for the home learning activity and in classroom activities and take decisions. How to tailor the content, how to tailor the activities, how to tailor the teaching practices, how to tailor the lecturing method, how to tailor the content, all together we may have to consider based on the outcome of the assessment during the decision making. Let us sensitize. What is learning? Learning can be defined as a change in behavior as a result of experience. Yes, being a performer also, they may have to change in their learning behavior. They have to move one level up and up day by day. Being a struggling students also, they may have to uplift their learning quality day by day. Average learners also, they may have to uplift themselves day by day. Definitely, there should be an incremental change in their learning behavior as a result of experience. We may have to cater to all the varied students. And let us reflect ourselves. What is teaching? Teaching includes all activities to provide education through interaction so that learners can stand on their own feet. When learners can stand on their own feet, when they are inculcating towards continuous learning, when they are ready for the lifelong learning, only then students can stand on their own feet. To bring the culture of continuous learning, to bring the culture of lifelong learning, flipped learning is the only avenue to nurture them towards self-learning. So let us reflect ourselves, or let us see what is the meaning of flipped classroom. Normally in the traditional classroom, we do lecture. Teacher does the lecturing method. Most of the time in the class, all the students starts listening to the teacher. And the student will be doing all the homework activities or problem-solving activities or programming activities or some of the learning activities at home. In the flipped learning, we may have to flip both of the activity. In the home, they may have to read by themselves. Lecture should be brought to the home. They may have to learn through their digital gadgets. they may have to watch the lecture. Before coming to the class, they may have to be thorough on the conceptual ideas, fundamentals. Then once the student comes to the class, they may have to involve in the activities, classroom activities. So teacher may have to help them learn to learn activities. Teacher may have to mentor them, guide them how to solve the problem, are relevant to the context or relevant to the course. They may have to guide, provide, nurture, facilitate, mentor them. So these two things are flipped in the traditional and in the flipped classroom. The flipped classroom is a blended learning strategy. Certain amount of learning happens beyond the classroom. Certain amount of learning happens within the classroom. So it is said to be blended learning strategy with the aim to improve students' engagement and outcomes. Only with the help of flipped learning, it is possible to engage with the students more and more to understand their needs and expectation. Accordingly, teacher can provide the support, help or facilitate, and we can meet the outcomes also. Any blended learning strategy that requires students to prepare learning before they meet the teacher or before they come to the class and engage with peers and a teacher with purposeful activities in a classroom. Let us go back to the history of flipped learning. Who introduced flipped learning in the academic world? In the academic world, the terminology or the philosophy of flipped learning is being introduced by Khan Academy, thanks to Khan Academy. Salman Khan is the founder of this Khan Academy, is the most recognizable contributor to the flipped classroom. Salman Khan founded Khan Academy based on this model, flipped learning model. The first university in the world adapted flipped classroom model in 2016 is MEF University, Istanbul. They do have publication subsequently. And flipped classroom, the very primary activity is content preparation and content delivery. Majorly, video lessons require for the flipped learning. Always visual learners start loving videos more. Visual learning will bring more retention among the students than the text reading, than the book reading. Video lesson will create a lot of excitement, interest and curiosity. Always curiosity, excitement and interest are the keystone for anyone's learning quality. So we can achieve better learning quality only with the aid of videos. So teacher have to prepare their own video, or they have the privilege to pick up third party online free resources, online video lectures, and suggested text materials along with videos. It is recommended to suggest some text materials, interactive multimedia materials and animations, etc. Provide online learning resources, curated content, the right content for the context. We may have to pick up flaw-free content, knowledge flaw as well as grammatical flaw-free content, as well as we may have to put effort in identifying the right resource to meet our learners' requirement, to meet the learning context. And provide opportunities for the interaction in and out of the class, even though we provide the content. With the Google Classroom, with the Gmail, with our WhatsApp, we can reach out our students to have interaction in and out of the class. Convey timely information, plan well ahead, and provide the content 1 week earlier to conduct the flipped classroom activities, or 10 days before. That is the right time, neither too early, not too long, or not too short. EDpuzzle can be used for self-learning activities or home learning activities. Capture data, provide feedback. EDpuzzle provides a lot of data based on the time spent in watching the video. How many times student watched? what is the portion of the video student watches repeatedly, and how the interactive quizzes taken part by the student. That is the power of EDpuzzle. Whereas the same flipped learning activity video content can be provided with the support of YouTube also, but learning analytics will become difficult to capture. So always it is advisable to use EDpuzzle to provide the video content. What are the challenges? Accessibility to the content and how to watch. These are all the challenges normally being a student they will be having. To resolve or to overcome these challenges, being a teacher, what we have to do? Watch the videos together. Couple of weeks, keep watching the videos within the class. Give a practice, bring that culture. So one or two videos, we may have to watch together inside the class, all along with the students, both teacher and students together have to watch the videos. Demonstrate how to practice, rewatch, and take notes. Always advisable to provide in the initial stages only 15 to 20 minutes video for the home learning activities. How to respond to EDpuzzle quizzes? We may have to demonstrate in the initial period, couple of weeks or one or two times. Show them the analytics, how EDpuzzle provides the learning analytics performance of the students and the individuals' information, assessment information, as well as the complete class assessment information. Demonstrate expected behavior among the students when we administer flipped learning. Hold them accountable and keep it simple. Get more time with your student. Then slowly they will attune to the expectation of the teacher. Slowly they will nurture themselves. They will raise themselves to meet the goals of the teaching learning practices. And flipped classroom, so far now we have discussed about what to be done at home. And within the classroom, how we may have to take care of the students and the learning activities. Once the materials are provided for the self-paced learning or video-based learning or home learning, inside the class, being a teacher, we may have to conduct learning activities. We can conduct one of the learning activities, very powerful, think, pair, share, or small group activities. For every activity, we may have to set the stage very properly. What is the expectation of this activity? During the activity, what is expected to do? What is the timeline? And what is the guidelines? Everything is to be provided well in advance and articulated very well. And students' presentation also we can do within the classroom. So this is one kind of ambience or activity we can provide when we administer flipped learning activities. Play students' recorded video also. Ask them to create recorded video, either audio or video, and ask them to bring that video inside the class. Ask them to play those videos within the class. Next, enable learners in the higher order thinking. Inside the class, avoid a simple definition and giving fundamentals. All the fundamental simple definitions we may have to flip towards the home learning activities or self-learning activities. When they come inside the class, we may have to gear up their thinking level. We may have to brainstorm with them why that concept is useful, where it is applicable, what is that concept, who will get benefited, how this algorithm works. These are all the way we may have to elevate their higher order thinking. Effective questioning. The meaning of effective questioning is not to fetch the information from the rote learning memory. They may have to think a while. They may have to induce inductive reasoning, deductive reasoning has to be done with the question, and with that deduction, they may have to provide the answer. Such a kind of question is said to be effective questioning. And within the classroom, teacher can enhance the problem solving skill. And within the classroom, teacher can elicit mathematical usage, how the formulas are applied in this graphical representation or in the application context or in the laboratories or in the experimentations or product design, something like that we may have to do usefully and meaningfully within the class. And we may have to demonstrate more real-time examples and applications inside the class. Take them to the laboratory, go beyond the set syllabus and accelerate them to design experiments and prototyping, and go for in-depth laboratory experimentation and administer more project-based learning, mini project, or the experiment which requires higher order thinking skill. Set the experiment which requires more critical thinking skill. So that should be the purpose of visiting the classroom or coming to the institution. All the home learning activities, we may have to flip the fundamentals and the conceptuals and the definitions. When they come inside the class, we may have to make them to interact with their peers, interact with the teacher, and teacher may have to plan such a way that the student's activity should meet the higher order thinking level. And the another way, document analysis. In the forthcoming video, I'll be discussing about how we can do document analysis in detail. Keep watching and subscribe the channel too. If you subscribe, automatic notification, you will get to know. And administer, bring the document, bring the graphical representation, discuss within the class all along with the students, point out the mistakes and provide the positive ambience in the classroom. And with the help of some other students, keep correcting that mistakes and provide them the closure and reflections. If the data varies, how the graph varies, and facilitate peer reviewing, provide the rubrics for the peer reviewing, facilitate the self-reviewing, provide the rubrics for the self-reviewing. Peer reviewing, self-reviewing strategies I will be discussing in the forthcoming videos. Keep watching. Discussing real-time example and application, collaborative discussion, brainstorming, we may have to do within the class. Enable them to do these three inside the class. This is also another approach. Variety and varied of approaches I'm giving to do inside the class when we bring the approach flipped learning concept. And the essential activities, encourage your students to raise questions. Encourage your students to get clarified with their doubts. Provide more feedback and closure and reflections. Clarifying students' doubt is also a primary goal of flipped learning activity. Provide guidance. Provide feedback. How to solve the problem? How to build the next step of the logic? How to understand the design? How to do the design of experimentation? Something like that teacher may have to provide in the classroom activities when we approach flipped learning concept. And how to deal with adults? This is the key point to overcome a lot of difficulties when we use flipped classroom strategy. Celebrate the student's success within the class, the easiest way to engage your student. Always the success students ought to be showcased in the class. Celebrate all along with the students. Critical feedback is to be provided in the personal zone. Self-esteem is a key to engage teenagers. All the appreciation is to be done in the class. All the feedback or any criticism we may have to provide in the personal zone. This is the way we may have to deal with adults. One of the technology, Zoom software. We can use the Zoom software for the video recording. Right now in this video, I am using Zoom software for this recording. So Zoom software helps us to record our own lectures or our own demonstration. Numerous features are there. Already have provided the demonstration and how to use Zoom software for the video recording in my previous videos. Keep watching and subscribe the channel. And EDpuzzle is a fantastic or magical tool for administering home learning activities. If students forget their password or username, within the EDpuzzle, it is easy to manage. Go to the tab My Classes, and within the My Class, you could notice the members and you could notice password management. With this support, you can resolve the issue of this password and username maintenance. YouTube channel, this is another avenue to create a gallery or archive your videos, or pick any video and create a gallery. Announce this YouTube channel link to your students for the home learning activities or self-learning activities or the video-based learning activities. What is the benefit of flipped learning? Flipped learning plus active learning. We may have to create the environment in the class to enable thinking capacity of the student. When we make our learners to think more and more, then it becomes active learning. With the help of flipped learning and active learning, amazing educational possibilities we could notice. Allows teachers to engage their students in the meaningful way. Because most of the time in the traditional approach, teacher involves in building the fundamentals, providing the concepts and definitions, drawing the diagram on the board. When we flip these all the fundamentals in the home learning activities inside the class, much more meaningful way we can engage our students towards higher order thinking. That is the advantage and benefit of flipped learning. To achieve the outcome-based learning, this is the only avenue. Otherwise, always time management will be the problem. We cannot meet out individuals' expectations. Benefits. Number one, learner-centric approach. Always flipped learning helps for learner-centric approach. We are taking into consideration of performers, average learners, as well as struggling students. So we can tailor our content, we can talk to them, we can provide the guidance according to their need, according to their difficulty. That is added advantage within the flipped classroom. The second advantage, mastery-based learning. This is the approach we can administer for the performers. We can provide much more challenging problems. We can provide much more advanced topics. We can administer project-based learning, product-based learning, so problem-based learning. These are all the learning variety we could provide for the performers. Mastery-based learning suitable for the performers. Now we are taking care of learner-centric approach. The next method, engaged learning. Most of the time, inside the class, we can get an opportunity to engage with each and every student. We can provide emotional connect, better rapport, better guidance we can provide, because all the concepts, all the fundamentals, diagrams we'll be discussing either through video-based learning or preparing the best material and providing them before coming to the class. So in the class, we can do much more engaged discussion. And another benefit is differentiated learning. With the support of flipped learning activity, we could differentiate who are all in the advanced level, who are all in the struggling level, who are all in the average level. Depending upon the category, we can keep conducting the problems, we can keep conducting the activities, we can pose challenges, or we can tailor the contents or method of guidance or providing our support to the students based on their needs and their tendencies or learning behavior. Personalized learning also possible only when we administer more flipped learning. One-on-one, based on their need to meet out their expectation, to meet out their learning style, to meet out their caliber. When the teacher takes any efforts and support, then it is termed as personalized learning. This is also possible only with the support of flipped learning. These are all the expected benefits when we increase more and more flipped learning. How many flipped learning concepts we may have to bring in your course? It's up to teacher dependent and the learner dependent. Perhaps very few topic initially you can start with. Later on, you can go for larger amount of concepts, flip into the self-paced learning, inside the class, conduct more and more activities, do more experimentation, enable their higher order thinking. Or if the ambience supports, flip the entire course inside the class, much more meaningful way you can occupy. Enable their critical thinking, enable their reflective thinking, enable their innovative thinking. Administer master-based learning, administer project-based learning, administer problem-based learning. Then these are all the avenues you can take part. You decide being a teacher. You know the ambience better than me. Depending upon your ambience, you can start with one topic for the flipped classroom. Later on, once your student and yourself become familiar with the flipped learning, you can go for larger portion of the syllabus. Then you can flip the entire course in the flipped learning concept. Wish you all success. Keep watching. Subscribe the channel for more videos. Thank you.